the wilderness. Cold, bleak, and uninviting. Exactly the kind of place you wouldn't expect to find two lazy adolescents from Newcastle.
I am Johnny Saverston.
Hello, I am Thomas Evans.
Tommy and Johnny have decided to go back to basics and see if they could survive a journey of over 40 miles through remote, uninhabited wilderness with only a few basic tools and a film crew to document the experience.
To go back to more of a basic level of like living and stuff is quite a sort of interesting thing. There's a lot of programs like based on survival.
Most of the people on these programs are probably, well, fit, healthy.
We're the polar opposite of most of the people that are on those sort of programs.
With only 3 weeks remaining until their departure, the boys need to step up their fitness regime.
After no preparation, I know I'm meant to start sort of exercising, getting more healthy, but I haven't done anything yet.
All right, let's go.
After demonstrating their lack of physical fitness, the boys are asked to come to the preparation base, where a surprise is in store.
Dear survivors, what you have with you in a survival situation can be the difference between life and death.
Well, yes, that's true.
You'll be able to take 3 items each.
You have 1 minute to choose.
Jesus. All right. Let's do this. Right. Toss. Definitely. Now I've been told 1 beer represents 6 beers. I'm going for 6 beers. Lighter, yes, handy, but we want to do it the proper way with the
Sauce Striker then.
Sauce Striker, flinty thing.
Go with water container.
Water container, good choice.
Which knife?
Do we need a knife?
Whatever we'd use a knife for, would we use an axe
yeah,
for?
Yeah, yes.
Let's get an axe.
I do want to take one of them, I think.
Survival bag.
Day has finally arrived, and Tommy and Johnny are making their way to the drop-off point. The boys will be travelling from where they are dropped across the wild and rough terrain of southern Scotland. They'll be passing over the Scottish border, making their way through remote, uninhabited moorland and into Kielder Forest. Eventually, if all goes to plan, they will end up at the edge of Kielder Water and civilization, where their journey will end. The lads set off with the aim of walking 10 miles before the night starts to set in. Walking through rough forest terrain can quickly take its toll on the body's resources. It's very important to keep hydrated, so at the first chance they get, the boys fill up their water containers.
Water. Look at the colour of that. Look at that.
Yeah. I'm happy with that. That's fresh.
Yeah.
Yeah, so first day out?
Yeah. I'm feeling really good about it.
I'm enjoying it at the moment, I'm enjoying life at the moment. Having some fruit.
Cheers.
You know, we've filled up our canteens.
Yep.
Nice river water.
Oh yeah.
It's actually quite nice.
I think we'll do just fine. Okay. Here is our home for the night.
See what happens when it gets dark.
Yep. The real test is tonight when it's trying to sleep.
Hanging from here to here, top. That way, lying like here. So, what we want
these two ends will tie it to the tree.
Here, you knotted. I've forgotten how to knot.
The night is setting in, and after erecting their tarpaulin, the boys will need to light a fire if they're going to stay warm and keep their spirits up.
Well, as you can see, we've collected all our bits and bobs for a fire. We've got some tinder, which
I don't know what it is.
It's like some nice fluffy stuff, and it looks good to me. I think it's gonna straight away. That's my prediction. Well, if we'd chose the lighter instead, this would have been a lot easier. It's hard work.
I'm trying to think if we're doing something wrong.
Oh, Jesus Christ, we're wearing this down.
I know.
Obviously, the lighter was the obvious choice, but it's too easy. We thought, you know, that we
yeah, this is just too hard.
I thought it would take a while, but didn't think it would take this long. So we've got no food and no fire. Well.
Without a fire or any food, the boys turn in for the night.
I'd say morale is low right now.
I think it's mostly just boredom, innit?
Yeah.
It's just boring.
Honestly, if we had a fire going, this would be a different story.
Oh, tell you what, this is going to be a nightmare.
What's the time, like?
8 o'clock.
8 o'clock?
Oh. God.
The morning eventually arrives and the lads have made it through the night. But with little energy and no sleep, morale is low.
It's absolutely freezing. And as you can see, we didn't get the fire going, which is which would have made it a lot nicer. But didn't really get much sleep. Didn't get to eat any food apart from some clovers. Quite a horrible evening. I couldn't do that again without a fire. Literally, I would just not be able to do it.
The boys are trying to keep up the pace they set themselves on the first day. However, with no food in their stomachs, their energy levels are very low. So when Tommy comes across some wild dandelion roots, the pair try to satisfy their hunger.
I'm just praying this tastes all right.
Oh, that's bitter.
The boys need to cover 15 miles if they're going to keep to their plan of crossing the border and reaching Kielder Forest by nightfall. Unfortunately, the walking seems to be taking its toll on Johnny.
Absolutely knackered today. Slept last night with no fire, so didn't really sleep much, and now no food today either, apart from that thing, would I say. And then got to walk loads uphill, and it's pretty hard. I think when I get home, I'm just gonna like buy all my favourite foods and have a massive shower and just watch telly for about 3 days and eat all the food. Can't wait to set up camp somewhere, and who knows, we might get a fire tonight, and I'm just going to go to bed and cry.
After another hard afternoon of walking, the lads find a small stream which they use to refill their water containers.
We've been walking loads, came down here, and then we found this nice little bit of waterfall finally got some nice water, filled it up nice and cold, and just nice and refreshing. First proper bit of anything we've had. Spirits are up a little bit and we haven't got far to walk till we're going to set up camp, so I think everyone's a bit happier now.
With spirits raised and the night setting in, the boys need to look for somewhere to camp.
Right, so we're going to set the camp sort of amongst these trees tonight. Hope we find a nice spot. We're going to go looking for wood. Hopefully, attempt two of making a fire will be a bit more successful. This time it just worked. It's just one of those things. Today we did to a big walk, very big. Plan for tomorrow, more walking. You know, we're sort of getting towards the end, so I think we'll keep pushing, we'll be happy.
It's the morning of day three, and hopefully the boys' last day in the wild. They need to cover 10 miles of rough ground if they want to get to Kielder water and civilization before another night sets in. But they are both exhausted.
I don't feel very well this morning.
Poo.
You what?
Poo.
I think I need a poo, yeah. I was thinking of just going over there, have a poo. It's quite sort of visible wherever you go.
The boys pack up their equipment and set off for the final time. Despite their lack of energy, the prospect of reaching the end and getting some well-deserved food gives them some much-needed motivation. Kielder water stretches out before them. The boys begin to reflect on the experience of the last 3 days.
It's been quite an accomplishment that we've managed to do this. We're used to not worrying about survival, what houses and heating and modern luxuries.
Yeah, I think the main conclusion is that we don't like being outdoors.
Yeah. I think every night when it was freezing cold, we wanted to go home, but we've done it. I'll look back and think, yeah, that was good, but I'll definitely won't be doing that again.
I'm very, 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 very glad it's over.
I think the conclusion is that we're just
not built for it.
No. we're too used to the comfort of the way we live. It would be nice to think that's changed, but
no.
It's just sort of made it more obvious, I'd say.